And we're ready to go. Should be pretty nice glide today. Temperature is pretty good. It's like -2, I think. Pretty long uphill in the beginning, so I'm gonna try to go pretty slow here in the beginning. Then we have one more uphill, and then it's the big downhill. Stream seems to be running still, but that's good. Get ready for the big downhill, guys. Quite a big downhill right there. And it's really good glide today, so we went pretty fast. Probably 50 kilometers an hour. Can take a small break here now. That was one lap, 2.3 kilometers, I think. Do you guys think that the camera angle is good on my head? I can adjust it a bit if you want. But I think it was pretty good. Pretty good height. But here you can see the whole track goes up there, then up there, comes back down there, goes up again, and then comes back down here. Thank you. Hope it's not too dark for you guys. It's pretty dark out here even though the lights are on. Again, big downhill. Almost lost it there. It's quite speedy there and it turns also a little bit the whole time, so you could pretty easily fall down there. And now I also have my kind of worse skis. I have a pair of better skis. With those it would be really fast down the hill there. one downhill into another. This is probably the steepest part. Yeah, let's take a break after this lap. But yeah, really nice skiing weather. Only thing for you guys is that it might be a little bit dark to see anything. But I guess you see something at least. It's a pretty dark picture with the GoPro. But I guess you'll able to see something. Yeah, I'm gonna do at least one more lap. guess I could do this shorter lap too. So get in a little bit less uphill. A little bit more easy double pole. Thank you. Yeah, it can be a bit tough up the hills, but you just need to go slow enough, then it's no problem. But the downhills are a good part. And it's nice to be able to ski even though there's no natural snow, but this track has good artificial snow. Take a small break here. Yeah, plus 10. Here it's the temperature is just perfect now. It's just below zero. Maybe minus 2 degrees. But here you can see where the track goes. First it comes up there. Then it goes around there, comes up here, goes around there and comes here and goes down over there. Yeah, it would be probably easier to go around this with a bike, but I really like the skiing part. It's really nice. And I do the only the double poling, so it might seem that I go pretty heavy when I go in the uphills. If I would have kick wax and go like diagonal, it would at least seem easier, I think. But I like doing only the double poling. But yeah, let's continue on. And really the skiing is really good for your back. At least if I have a little bit sore back, if I go out and ski a bit, then my back is fine after that. So it's really good for my upper body strength. Yeah, that's also one thing. If you have bad knees, classical style is pretty good. If you do freestyle skiing, that's a lot worse on the knees, I think. Because this classical, you're always going straight forward. So it doesn't torque or bend your knee in like bad angles. And if you do the only downhill skiing, like the big downhills, there you have different skis and all, and that's really heavy on the knees too. But this classical style double purling, it's pretty easy on the knees. You do most of the work with the upper body. Okay, here we go, the big downhill. Let's take some speed away by standing up and then go down here in the tough part. Now I've done four laps against the whole track. Still gonna do a few of the shorter ones here to kind of cool down so that you don't go full speed and then suddenly stop. No, I'm not training for competition. It's just to keep myself in some kind of shape. So during the summer when you sit in the tractor, when you have a good condition, it's much easier to sit and do a long day in the tractor. And it's nice to go outside. I like doing outside work and being outside. Feels good, man. Nice and fresh air. Of course, I have done. Once I skied 90 kilometers in one day. It was kind of a competition, but not really. So yeah, the 90k I did one day, it was the Vasaloppet. I don't know if you know what that is, but it's a pretty legendary competition in Sweden. But yeah, I think there's quite a lot of things you can do outside that are not that expensive. I mean, if you got a bike, you get a decent bike for, I guess, 300 euros maybe. With that you can go and do a lot of biking. It's more like what you like to do. I also do a bit biking during the summer, but in the winter I like skiing more. And I mean, yeah, walking the dog, that's a good way to do exercise too. I mean, it's more what you like to do. Yeah, I think, isn't it Netherlands is really good for biking, I think. They have a lot of those separate biking lanes, I meant to say. But I guess Belgium is the neighbor, right? But maybe they don't like bikers in Belgium. It's a little bit the same here in Finland. If you ride a bike and get into some accident, it's always the biker's fault. But yeah, when you ski, here's usually pretty good with room. But now when here's no snow except on the track, then every skier comes here. So here's quite a lot of people actually now. It's in the evening already, but here's at least like 20 cars, 30 cars. But yeah, I have done a few of those longer, like you could, I guess you could call them competitions. There's like the pros that do it, but also casual skiers like myself can take part. So I've done the Vasaloppet, I've done that was in Sweden. Then one, the Ylläslevi in Lapland I have done, that was 70 kilometers. And then a couple of times in Lahti, the 50K. And all those competitions are kind of, I think they're really, really well organized. Like there's the pros and the casuals ski in the same competition. So it's pretty, it's a good feeling, even though you're not fighting for the win or anything like that, but it's nice to be a part of it. But yeah, the Vasaloppet, that was pretty legendary. When you're in the start there, there's usually about 15,000 people in the one competition. So in the start, it was a big field full of skiers. It was pretty unique feeling being there, like something like 8 in the morning, and there's 15,000 people waiting for the gun to fire off and everyone to start skiing. And luckily enough, I managed to finish the competition. It took me like 10 hours, but at least I finished it. It was a real good feeling to cross the finish line. But yeah, I'm gonna do maybe a couple of these shorter laps still. And then it's gonna be a good session for today. A little bit over 10 kilometers, I guess. Thank you. So I think that's about a good session for today. Did about an hour, a bit over. That's a good, probably like a little over 10 kilometers. Let's unhook the battery so we can take a sip from here. But yeah, so this was a good stream. Good stream in the dark. The GoPro seems to work nicely. And it has stayed on for 1 hour now, so when there's good enough internet signal, it seems to work well.